Hey there, my name is Mickey from the Tynker Game Dev Team, and today I want to show you how to use our music library to make a colorful visualizer that makes actors move to your music notes. We call it the glidophone. Don't worry, if you don't know how to read sheet music or don't have any musical knowledge, you can still follow along anyway, and at the end, you'll have a basic melody. First, let's choose a background for our project. Clicking this gear and add background, we can choose any of these that we like. I'm going to scroll down to music and choose one of these. I like this one. Next, we'll need some actors to represent the gliding actor and the keys. We can choose a theme for our project. For my theme, I'll use underwater. So I'll click add actor with media library and scroll down to ocean. And I'll add a starfish, and I'll also add, the manta ray. I'll rename the manta ray to glider, and the starfish to key. That way, you can use whatever theme you like and still follow this tutorial. To set our project up, let's go into the stage actor and use an on start block. We'll use the set tempo block and set our tempo to 130 beats per minute. We'll also need to create some variables. We're going to create three variables. One of them is called numKeys, and this represents the number of keys in our glidophone. We'll also have one called beats, and this will be the length of a beat in time. And the last thing we're going to have is keys, and this will be a list. We can use these set blocks to set what these variables would be right at the beginning. For now, we're going to have 12 keys, and the beat is 60 seconds divided by our current tempo. We can use this operator, type in 60, and get our tempo. The tempo right now is 130. This way, if we change this, it'll also change it here. Lastly, for keys, we want to set it to a new list. Next, what we want to do is clone the starfish or the key actor. To do this, we're going to use a script variable and a for loop. You can add to this and use this right here. For variable from 0 to numKeys, step by 1. And we'll use broadcast or send message. So we'll send the message clone to the key actor with variable. Now let's set up the starfish or the key actor. Inside the key actor, we want the starfish to hide at the beginning. Later, we'll have the clone show up. In the starfish, we'll need to make another variable called key number or key num. This will be a private variable only for the starfish or the key actor that will store what key it is. Next, we need a when I receive block. If we click this, it'll already have the clone message. When I receive clone, we're going to want to set key num to the received value that we have given it. The next thing we're going to do is actually create a clone. So when I receive the message clone, set key number, and then create a clone of the key. Oops. If we run this, nothing will happen just yet. Since we hit the main actor on start, we're going to have to show each clone. So what we can do is in clone startup, we can put show. Right now, if we run it, all the clones will be in the same spot. However, what we're gonna do is we're gonna have the starfish clones or the key clones go from the bottom left of the screen all the way to the right of the screen. We can do this using the goto block. Right now, if we put the goto block to minus 250, the starfish will go to the bottom. And this is where we want it to go, but the X position we want it to change. To do this, we're going to have to use some small math. We want to find the width of the whole screen, so we can do screen right minus screen left. And we want each starfish to be placed throughout the bottom of the screen. We can do this using another operator. If we get the key num and divide it by the number of keys, and we get all of this and multiply it by the full length of the screen, we can have the starfish space it out evenly. If we put it in the X, we can see the starfish space out. However, it starts at 0. We want to start on screen left, so we can use a plus operator and use the screen left block. Now the starfish will spread out like this. You can see that they're kind of halfway through, so what we can do is use another operator block and have it so that it's screen left plus 50, and put this in here. And now they space them out more evenly. Lastly, in the starfish, we want each starfish to be a different color, or each key actor to be a different color. We can use this using the effect block. We can use the color effect. What this does is it changes all the colors in an actor by a value. So right now, if we have it to 0, it won't change anything. If we change it to, let's say, 30, all the actors will now be blue. However, we want them to be different. So we can use math again. We can actually copy this right here. And instead of this, we type in 50. So now it will be between 0 and 50, and each starfish will be a different color than the last one. Now we're going to move to the glider, or the manta ray. Similarly to the key, or the starfish actor, we're going to use an onStart and a hide. We're also going to create two new variables, a note variable and a target variable. The note variable will store what note to play, and the target variable will store which of the key or starfish actors to aim for. Previously in the stage, we had send message clone to key, and then we made a when I receive. This time we're going to do it the opposite way. We're going to make the when I receive block first, and when I receive go, we want to set the two variables that we just made. We want to set note and target. Note is going to become the received value. And target is actually going to come from the global list that we have called keys. So we can use get, and we can put keys right here. Get key 0 means to get the first thing. What we want to do is we want to get the note thing. So if our note is 0, it gets the first thing in the list. If our note is 1, it gets the second thing. However, with musical notes, you can keep going higher and wrap around. So what we're going to do is we're going to have the modulus, or mod, operator. So we're going to have note mod with num keys. What this does is it will wrap around. So if we have 12 keys, and if note equals 5, note mod 12 will be 5 still. But if we have 13 for note, 13 mod 12 will be 1. It gives us the remainder. This divided by this and the remainder is what mod is. Finally, we can create a clone after we've set all these variables. Create clone of self. Now, since we can create a clone, we should have a clone startup. In the clone startup, we're going to decide where the manta ray or the glider spawns. We can do this by deciding where the target is. If the target is on the right side, then we want the glider to spawn on the left, and vice versa. We can do this by using a script variable. We're going to rename this X, and we're going to use an if-else statement. In this if-else statement, we can use one of these operators, greater than. We're going to check if the X position of the target is greater than 0, which means it's on the right side. There's a handy block we have, a property block. We can use if this property of this object is greater than 0. So we can use x position of target. Then we can set this script variable x to be on the left side. Screen left. Otherwise, it would be screen right. And so we may have noticed that this get keys, right now the target is from get keys. And what the key is, it's list of these actors. And so what we need to do is we need to add the actor name, my actor name, whoops, to that list keys. So every time a key is created, it adds to this list, and then in this list keys, the target can be grabbed by the glider. So now on a clone startup, the glider will spawn on the left or the right side. We have the X position, but we still need the Y position. So what we're going to do is we're going to use a go-to block. This block will actually make the clone go to a certain spot. We can use this X, which will be either screen left or screen right, and we can use a random block. And this random block, we can choose it to go from 0 to the top of the screen. So we can put 0 and use screen top. Lastly, we want to show the actor now that it's in the right position. The last thing we can do to make the glider on the manta ray look right is have it point in the right direction. We can set the rotation style from all around to left or right. That way, the glider will only look left or right without tilting in any direction. We can also have it point towards our target. That way, it'll look the right way when it's aiming for the starfish or the key. With this positioning code done for the glider, now we can create clones on the stage. If we move back to the stage actor, we can copy this set of blocks. And instead of sending clone message, we can send a go message, and we'll do it to the glider. And what will happen now when we run it is that all the gliders will be created. So these are all the gliders ready to go in. So now we can add the movement. The movement in the glider can be added after the show block. And we can actually use something called glide, which is why we call these gliders. The glide block will have the actor move from its location to the given location over time. This will give a smooth animation and a smooth movement to the actor. We don't want to go to x0 and y0, but what we do want to use is we can use the same property block, use the x position, and use the y position. And if we glide 1 second, that might not be in time with our music. So what we can do is we can use our operator and have 2 times the beat. That way, it glides in time with our music. Lastly, after gliding, we want to play a note. So we can use our play note block. And instead of 60, we're going to use note for half a beat. And after it plays a note, it should delete this clone. Let's run it. As you can see, not all the actors actually made a noise that you can hear. It's because the note block that we have is really low. It's too low for us to hear easily. We're going to change this. To change this, we can take a look at our play note block. If we drag this out, we can see that 60 is our middle C of our musical scale. And so 72 is the next C note up. However, our note variable is from 0 to 12, which is too low on our scale and it's difficult to hear. What we can do is we can use an operator block and have 60 plus our note. And if we run this, you can see it plays, but it plays all at the same time. We can fix this. Going into the stage, we can use a rest block. If we put a rest after the send message, it'll wait half a beat before sending the next one. Perfect. Now that the gliders will go to the right key and play a sound, we can actually start making a song. So instead of having this loop that plays all the notes for us, we can take this out. And I've prepared a small little melody so we can try something else. What I've done here is I've sent a message and I've chosen 1, 3, 5, 7, a number that represents a note. I've waited with a rest and played more of these notes. And by putting these back to back, I can have the gliders come out and play that melody I wrote. Try changing around the values here and the rest beats so that you can have your own melody. Try making a melody that you've already heard before or creating something brand new. With this project being finished now, there's a lot of things that you can add. Besides making your own music, you can actually change what instrument's playing. Right now, the play note defaults to playing a piano, but you can use a set instrument block and you can choose from many different sounds that we have on Tynker. If I wanted to strip it to a trumpet, we can do that here. You can also change your theme around. You can have it so the glider, right when it glides after it plays its note, it can change its costume from a glider to something else. Or you can have the keys also do different things. There's a lot of things you can customize here, and we encourage you to try it out here with Tynker. Thanks for tuning in for this video, and I hope you enjoy playing with all the things that Tynker has to offer.